By watching this video, you are participating in a little social experiment of mine. An experiment which in some countries, including China, is actually illegal. And I bet you won't be able to figure out what the experiment is until I reveal it later in the video. I'm sure you've already asked yourself, how come that Siri, Alexa, and Google Voice are all so stupid? I mean, Siri may have been cool when it was released 11 years ago, but it cannot really do anything outside of a few pre-programmed functions. But what if there was a Siri or a chatbot that actually works? What if, in certain aspects, this chatbot was actually more competent than humans? This may sound like science fiction, but since a few weeks ago, with the public release of ChatGPT, it has become reality. To provide a few examples of what ChatGPT can do, I asked it how to represent a differential equation in LaTeX. And here is the result. The level of detail, including the example with code, is so remarkable. For comparison, here is what you get if you ask the same question to Google. And things got even crazier when I asked ChatGPT to write a program in Python using PyTorch to learn how to recognize handwritten digits. It didn't just provide a step-by-step tutorial how to do it, it actually wrote the entire program for me, including the training of the neural network. I also asked it to write a poem encouraging my viewers, yes, that's you, to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and the results are, well, honestly, it's way better than something that I would have written myself. A guy on the internet even asked it to write a biblical verse in the style of the King James Bible, talking about how you should remove a peanut butter sandwich from a VCR. However, when I tried to do the same, it ended up giving me a moral lecture about why it was wrong for me to misuse the Bible to promote my own YouTube channel. And I mean, it does have a point here, given that I already got quite a lot of heat for an inappropriate Bible joke that I made some time ago in my Dana Live video at MIT. By the way, if you're curious about that, you can check it out over here. One of the weak points of ChatGPT is, somewhat surprisingly, mathematics. It often fails at even very basic and simple logical questions. Here's an example. When I was 4 years old, my sister was half my age. Now I'm 27 years old. How old is my sister? At first, it actually got the correct answer and said 25. But then I copy-pasted that question into a new thread, and all of a sudden, it seems to have unlearned how time works, claiming that my sister is now 13 and a half years old. And in both cases, it appears to be 100% confident in its answer. I guess the principle fake it until you make it also applies to an AI. But this is something that the creators of ChatGPT have actually warned us about, because it all boils down to the difference between learning something and actually truly understanding it. As powerful as ChatGPT may seem, it often manages to trick us into thinking that it understands something, while it actually just memorizes a lot of information and then recalls it in a very smart way. If you're looking for a software that can actually solve math problems, you might be better off using something like GathMath, who kindly agreed to sponsor this video. GathMath is an AI-based math tool which can read and solve math problems by using your smartphone camera. So the way it works is you just download an app on your phone, you scan a problem, and then it uses an AI tool to solve it step by step. This works really well for word-based problems, geometry, algebra, logic, and even calculus. And if the AI tool doesn't have a solution ready, then it has the option to connect you with a real human expert who can just help you to solve the problem step by step. The automatic AI scanning function is free of charge, and if you want to get help from a real human being, you can do so by using their premium subscription. The subscription normally costs $12 per month, but with my discount code, you can get a 33% discount on the first month. Let's start with a high-level technical explanation of how ChatGPT works. If you're not interested in this, feel free to skip ahead to this timestamp to hear my thoughts on how ChatGPT will shape our future. So, how does ChatGPT work? At the very heart of ChatGPT's language processing capability lies a technique called transformer language models. There we go, that's how it's called. These models use artificial neural networks, which are computer programs designed to mimic the human brain works, to understand and respond to text input. But what sets transformer language models apart from regular neural networks is the way they process input data. Traditional neural networks process input data sequentially, which can limit their ability to understand context and relationships between different pieces of information. Transformer language models, on the other hand, use a parallel processing approach called self-attention, which allows them to more effectively analyze and understand complex relationships between different pieces of data. In order to generate responses, transformer language models pass the input data through several layers of these self-attention neural networks, and these self-attention neural networks were trained on massive datasets of human language. Basically, the entire internet. This allows the model to understand patterns and nuances of natural language and generate responses that sound more human-like and contextually relevant than ever before. But what can ChatGPT actually do? Possibilities are really endless. Anything from answering simple questions to engaging into very complex and meaningful conversations about any topic you can think of. In fact, every single word that I said in this video up to this point, except of course the examples, didn't come from me or any other human. You were just tricked by an AI and you had no idea about it. Don't believe me? Here's the actual screen recording of ChatGPT generating word by word everything that I said so far. By watching this video, you are participating in a little social experiment of mine. I'm sure you've already asked yourself, how come that Siri, Alexa, and Google Voice are all so stupid? I mean, Siri may have been cool when it was released 11 years ago, but it cannot really do anything outside of a few pre-programmed functions. So, how does ChatGPT work? At the very heart of ChatGPT's language processing capability lies a technique called transformer language models. There we go, that's how it's called. Generating this was actually super easy and only took me a couple of iterations with ChatGPT. First, I asked it to generate a script for my YouTube channel, including some technical details and some applications. Since ChatGPT cannot actually browse the internet and was only trained on the internet up to 2021, it doesn't yet know that I have a YouTube channel, so I first had to explain who my audience is and what the appropriate level of technical details was. And then, after a few iterations, it sounded just as if I had written the script myself. Even the sponsored mention by GathMath was actually AI generated. All I had to do was copy-paste the text and the bullet points which they sent to me, give it to ChatGPT, and it converted it into a very nice script. And then I just asked it to shorten it to 35 seconds so it would fit well into this video. The only thing that I had to do manually were the examples. And again, this is just because ChatGPT was trained on the internet up to 2021, and therefore it doesn't yet know about all these fun examples which are all generated in the last couple of weeks. And this is just the beginning. I bet that 1 year from now, ChatGPT will have watched all of my videos, so if I want to make a new video, I can just ask it to do this in one line, and it will understand exactly what I say, how I talk, how I write my video scripts, and what my opinions are. And for the remainder of this video, I'll be talking freely again, not using any kind of script that was AI generated, I promise. So I'm really curious what your thoughts are on this. First of all, are you surprised that ChatGPT is this advanced? And secondly, did you notice that anything that I was saying didn't really sound like it was coming from me? You can let me know in the comments down below, and while you're there, you can also hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notifications. And as an MIT Ph.D. candidate working on artificial intelligence, and yeah, even got a ring since very recently. So as a Ph.D. candidate working in AI, I want to provide you with my own personal opinion on where all of this is going to go and how it is going to impact us and society as a whole. I don't think that ChatGPT will actually become more intelligent than humans, at least not if we think about intelligence as human intelligence. But I do think that it will become more intelligent, and possibly already is, in a different way. You see, ChatGPT is able to watch every movie, read every article, read every book, listen to every song, and just get all the news articles and all the information that is out there. So the way you should think about it is as endlessly many small, but very fast brains that can just process a lot of data at once. And therefore, there isn't really any competition between us and the AI. On the contrary, you should think about it as something that can complement us, because our weaknesses are its strengths. And therefore, one of the major applications of ChatGPT will actually be search engines, as the CEO of OpenAI pointed out in a recent interview.
Quality of language models we'll see in the coming years, you know, there will be like a serious challenge to Google for the first time for a search product.
You see, Google has dominated the market of search engines simply because no competitor can actually do much better than them. And the reason for this is because, well, they already figured out kind of the best way to rank search results, and any competitor might just be able to do like marginally better, but that's certainly not enough to actually beat Google in the market. But in reality, very often when I search for something on the internet, I'm not actually looking for the best possible website. I just want to have the information directly without having to open a website. And this is something that Google has started to implement quite recently. So when you search for a certain term, you might get the answer directly, as you can see in this example, instead of just having to go to the actual website where the information comes from and then find it yourself. But this doesn't really work well when I'm looking for something that cannot just be answered with one word or one sentence, or something a bit more complicated. Also, two people searching the exact same thing on the internet may not be interested in the same results. For example, if I, as an engineer, want to know how an internal combustion engine works, I might be looking for results such as this one. But a 10-year-old might just not be interested in all these technical details, so ChatGPT can just create a summary and explain it in simpler terms. The really big question which I care about is, can ChatGPT generate net new knowledge for humanity? According to ChatGPT, the answer is no, Which kind of makes sense when you think about it, because all ChatGPT does is browses the entire internet and gathers a lot of knowledge, learns it, and then presents it in a very human-readable way. But if you ask the CEO of OpenAI, he thinks otherwise.
It's not going to go, like, create fundamentally new... It's not going to go cure cancer. It's not going to add to the sum total of human scientific knowledge. And that is what I think will turn out to be wrong that most surprises the current experts in the field.
This is a question which I personally really care about because I'm a scientist, not just an engineer. I'm actually a scientist at MIT. And I would like to really figure out if there's a way for ChatGPT or a similar model to advance human knowledge. If you would like to know more about this, or maybe you want me to make a separate video on this, you can let me know in the comments below. And also, if you have any video requests or suggestions, you know, related to ChatGPT or similar technologies, you can also just let me know in the comments and I might be able to make a video about this in the near future. If you enjoyed this video and learned something new, you can thank me by giving me a thumbs up and subscribing to my channel. And if you want to watch some more cool videos from me, you can check them out over here and here. As always, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time.